Hi, and welcome to Chapter 3, Weighing the Words. Here's where we're going. What makes an objective theory good? What makes an interpretive theory good? What's the contested turf and common ground among theorists? The work of social scientists and interpretivists is so different that it is natural that they have trouble understanding and valuing their counterpart scholarships. Twin objectives of scientific knowledge. It explains past and present. Predicts the future. There are four additional criteria for theories. Relative simplicity. Testability, practical utility, and quantifiable research. Scientific Standard 1, Explanation of the Data. An objective theory draws order out of chaos. It describes process, focuses attention on what's crucial, and helps us ignore that which makes little difference. The reason something happens becomes as important as the fact that it does happen. Scientific Standard 2, Prediction of Future Events. Objective theory predicts what will happen. It's only possible when dealing with things we can see, hear, touch, smell, and taste over and over again. In the social sciences, a certain humility on the part of the theorist is advisable. Scientific Standard 3, Relative Simplicity. Objective theory should be as simple as possible. The rule of parsimony, also known as Occam's razor, states that given two plausible explanations for the same event, we should accept the simpler version. Scientific Standard 4, a hypothesis that can be tested. Objective theory is testable. Falsifiability is the requirement that a scientific theory must be stated in a way that it can be tested and disproved if it is wrong. Some theories are so loosely stated that it's impossible to imagine empirical results that could disprove their hypothesis. Scientific Standard 5, Practical Utility. A good objective theory is useful. Lewin argues there is nothing as practical as a good theory. Scientific Standard 6, Quantitative Research. Most scientific research depends on a comparison of differences. An experiment is a research method that manipulates a variable in a tightly controlled situation in order to find out if it has the predicted effect. A survey is a different research method. This research method uses questionnaires and structured interviews to collect self-reported data that reflects what respondents think, feel, or intend to do. There is no universally approved model for interpretive theories. Interpretive theories seek to create understanding, identify values, inspire aesthetic appreciation, stimulate agreement, reform society, and conduct qualitative research. Interpretive Standard 1, New Understanding of People. Interpretive theory offers fresh insight into the human condition. A theorist might typically examine a one-of-kind speech community that exhibits a specific language style. The self-referential imperative is that you should include yourself as a constituent of your own construction. In other words, you're accountable to what you construct. Interpretive Standard 2, Clarification of Values. An interpretive theory brings people's values out into the open. Theorists should reveal ethical commitments. The ethical imperative is that we should grant others that occur in a construction the same autonomy that one practices in constructing it. Interpretive Standard 3, Aesthetic Appeal. Interpretive theory can capture readers' imaginations. It's the critic's job to spark appreciation. Interpretive Standard 4, Community of Agreement. The interpretive theory must be supported by other scholars. It must become the subject of widespread analysis. Interpretive Standard 5 is the reform of society. Interpretive theory often generates change. Critical interpreters are reformers who can have an impact on society. Critical theorists are scholars who use theory to reveal unjust communication practices that create or perpetuate an imbalance of power. Interpretive Standard 6, Qualitative Research. Interpretive scholars use words to support their theories. Textual analysis is a research method that describes and interprets characteristics of any text. Ethnography is a research method of participant observation designed to help a researcher experience a culture's complex web of meaning. Contested turf and common ground among theorists. Points of contact. Explanation creates understanding. Prediction and value clarification look to the future. Simplicity has an aesthetic appeal. They both seek to achieve a community of agreement. A theory that reforms unjust practices is practical. And they both exhibit a commitment to learn more. So here's a summary for evaluating communication theory. The scientific theory and the interpretive theory. With the scientific theory, you have explanation of the data, prediction of the future, relative simplicity, testable hypotheses, practical utility, and they use more quantitative research. With interpretive theories, you have understanding of people, clarification of values, aesthetic appeal, community of agreement, reform of society, and they tend to use more qualitative methods of research.